Good afternoon, Facebook. Good afternoon to our lovely Facebook audience and to all our Facebook fans. It's the Made Simple group here, and we're back again with another Facebook Live. So today we are streaming live from Ceviche Restaurant in Old Street, London. And we're very excited today because we have the pleasure of interviewing Martin Morales. Now, Martin Morales is an award-winning chef. He's a restaurateur, he's an art producer, and he's an author of a cookbook. So Martin, do you want to give a quick wave?
Hello.
The audience there. So you may recognise or may have seen Martin, and he's been on BBC Saturday Kitchen and on his YouTube channel before as well. So Martin, I'm going to put the camera over onto you because you're the interesting one here. So before we get into talking about how you started up a business, just want to tell our Facebook audience a little bit about Ceviche.
Ceviche is a restaurant in Soho. It was the first restaurant we opened. It's called Ceviche Soho. We opened that 4 years ago, and we specialize in coastal food from Peru. Ceviche Old Street, where we are now, is a completely different restaurant. We opened Ceviche Old Street over a year ago, and it's also an art gallery, so it's a contemporary Peruvian art gallery. We showcase the works of over 50 of Peru's best contemporary artists, as well as, because it's a large restaurant in Old Street here, we also showcase the cuisine of all four corners of Peru. We also have another unique and different restaurant called Andina in Shoreditch, which is like a picanteria, a family-run restaurant in the Andes of Peru, inspired by my grandmother, who was an Andina. And we also have a gorgeous restaurant we just opened called Casita Andina, which is almost like the sister restaurant of Andina, but it's also completely different. And we've been inspired by the gastronomy and the cuisine of Cusco and the region in the Andes that is near Cusco as well. It's a gorgeous little restaurant in Soho. So those are the four restaurants that we run, all different, all unique, all gorgeous, and award-winning. So yeah.
Fantastic. So Martin, in the past you've worked for huge companies like Apple and Disney before you decided to start your own business. So what made you want to go it alone?
Look, working with Steve Jobs is fascinating, but so is working with young talent, with new people. So I've also worked with startups through my career. I started off working in music, started off as a DJ, but also then producing music, making records, doing remixes for Basement Jacks or for Ojos de Brujo or different types of artists, and then working through the industry of music, signing bands like Katie Tunstall, working with Josh Stone, and then just, you know, I guess what I really wanted to do, you know, the calling for Peruvian food came to me because that's where I grew up. My roots are from Peru, and I just wanted to get back to creativity and to cooking with my hands and working with my hands. Instead of having sort of, you know, more executive role, I guess.
Yeah.
And going back, you know, pushing myself. There was a point in my life that I said, look, you know, I've got as high as I can in the music industry. I've had an incredible time, learned from some incredible people. But I want to push myself more. You know, I love to be challenged. And so 5 years ago, I said, look, enough's enough. This idea that I've had for many, many years of starting my own restaurant needs to happen, so I'm going to make it happen.
Did it. You stepped outside your comfort zone and made
indeed,
it happen. What would you say are the biggest pain points about starting your own business?
Well, at the point where I was, you know, I was in a comfortable job, was very well paid, and I had a lot of responsibility, not just for the team that I run and the business that I run for Disney at the time, and then before that Apple, but also I have a beautiful wife and two gorgeous little young kids and a humongous mortgage to pay. Mm-hmm. So to throw away my full-time job and say, look, I'm going to pursue this dream, this incredible challenge of starting something that never existed in this country before. Oh,
no,
it's back.
You're still good. bear with us, we are live, so yeah. There's always a little technical glitch.
So, you know, that moment was really, really challenging. My wife supported me, as she always has done. We've been together since after I left university, since I was starting my working life. So we started our working lives together. And we've always believed in doing what we love.
Yeah.
And that's also what my great aunts and my grandmother taught me back in Peru. My grandmother was an Andina, a lady from the Andes, and she taught me those values of just following your dreams and doing what you love, and cooking has always been there. So I said, look, I'm going to forfeit and risk financial stability just to follow that dream so that my day-to-day can be as happy as it can be.
Fantastic. Your auntie sounds like a wise lady.
She is indeed.
So I guess you kind of really answered this question, but just to confirm really, what do you like most about being your own boss? Obviously you're doing what you love every day now.
I think for me, ultimately, and I realised that many years later, probably just recently, I'm a creative. I'm a creative at heart. I think of ideas and I make them happen. And I do that with the support of phenomenal people around me, whether it's our executive chef or whether it's our head of drinks or whether it's our operations director. But at heart, I have ideas that I research the hell out of, and I test drive in weird and funky ways and in small and big ways. And then we go out to kill,
yeah.
Go out to make it happen. And we're relentless in the pursuit of making that happen. And that's what I love most. That's that determination that you have to have in overcoming, fighting against all odds to make something happen. Something that, in my case, that I truly believe is healthy for the world, it makes a lot of people happy, enriches people's lives. And that's the power of Peruvian food.
It's the power of food as well.
Yeah.
So that's what you love to do. Is there anything as a business owner, because obviously our audience here, most of them small business owners, that you find a challenge or you don't like that comes with the kind of business owner, you know?
I guess I'd probably bore you with the restrictions that government institutions put on you. They don't make it easy. You know, we are creating, we're entrepreneurial, we're putting our necks out, we're risking everything that we have, and we're creating jobs, stability, and bringing wealth for others as well. And it's tough, you know. What we create is so, so beautiful. We always say that our restaurants serve Michelin standard food, but without the fuss. Super stylish, with the most incredibly high standard of ingredients. And a lot of care and love into what we do. We have a motto, aquí se cocina con cariño, which means here we cook with love. And that's something that was handed down to me by my grandmother. And we apply that to every single part of detail in our restaurants. And to follow that, but also keep, you know, very, very thin margins, and then be, you know, have tough taxes, tough restrictions on business that are increasing more and more. And the threat of those, particularly with Brexit now, is daunting.
Yes. You want to stay true, don't you?
And you want to stay true. You want to absolutely make customers really, really happy so they have a wow experience, a memorable experience, and they just feel great. But with all that, with all these restrictions, it's tough. So that's the greatest challenge. That's where we all need help, everyone involved in hospitality, in all kinds of areas of hospitality.
Okay, fantastic. So as a business owner, do you find a challenge to create that work-life balance? So what do you do to get away from the business, to clear your head?
I'm a runner, so
okay.
I run four times a week. I run for 15 minutes a day, more if I can,
yeah.
And I absolutely love it. I find it very relaxing. I find it it's my time.
Yeah.
And I also, you know, and I just, I think it's incredibly healthy. I like to eat well, but eat very healthily, because I want to feel great and I want to look great. So, you know, as best as I can at my age. And I want to be there for my kids. So I spend a lot of time with my wife and my kids. As much as I can at the weekends, as much as I can in the evenings. In the beginning of our business, I was working crazy hours. I was trying to maximize every single minute, to think of every single possible idea. And I had many, many more responsibilities because I was the startup owner. You know, what we started 5 years ago was just with one person, that was me. We had zero restaurants, zero revenue, zero sales, zero staff. Now we have almost 200 staff. We have about £8 million worth of sales a year, four restaurants, a beautiful record company, a beautiful art gallery, a charity that we support called Amantani, And you know, we've served over a million people. So I'm very, very proud of that. I have a lot of respect for that. But now I have a team that can help support that, and a team where I've given them the platform, the environment to be creative and to be brilliant and to be excellent and to do all the work that is alongside my work.
Yeah, to do it just as well as you would if you're doing it yourself.
I think it's, you know, I planted the first seed and now we have several trees. That's how I like to think of it. Yeah. And it's their character, personality and responsibility that has an experience that has really shaped where we're going right now.
That's fantastic. And sorry, just remind us, how many years that take from when you started out to now?
Just over 4 years.
Wow, yeah, that's amazing. So what are your thoughts on the boom in street food businesses? Because obviously very popular at the moment. Do you think now is the perfect time for people to be thinking about entering the food industry?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, I think, you know, eating encompasses all kinds of experiences, all kinds of arts. You know, that's what we value, the experience of eating alongside that of beautiful art, photography, cinema, film, stage, music. And so there's no boundaries within the creativity. So if people want to eat when they're in a restaurant, in a rooftop, in a car park, in their car, you know, at home, they want information online, it's all incredible. My humble mission is to get people excited about Peruvian food.
Yeah.
I start with restaurants, but as you know, we've got Martin's Peruvian Kitchen, our YouTube channel, you know, where every week we show a different recipe. So we have different shows every week at 7 o'clock. So subscribe, everyone. Subscribe to Martin's Peruvian Kitchen.
Shameless plug.
That's my ethos. So I think it's a phenomenal time to be involved in any aspect of food and be entrepreneurial with food, whether it's in delivery, whether it's in street food, whether it's with a van, whether it's servicing and catering offices, whether it's sort of half cooked or semi cooked, or whether it's just with ingredients, whether it's making little chili sauces, which we also do.
Yeah.
It's wide open. It's an incredibly creative space right now.
Okay, fantastic. So how do you see the future of Ceviche over the next few years?
We want to continue to be a small independent boutique restaurant company. Each different, each unique, each loved, each successful. We've not made any mistakes, any big mistakes in the last 4 years, and we hope we don't in future. Maybe we'll open a restaurant, but we only open a new restaurant, but we only open a restaurant if we think we've got a great story to tell. We have a new area of gastronomy to really talk about.
So there's a reason behind it,
Exactly, and if we find a great space. As you know, all our restaurants are in beautiful buildings that have history, have heritage and personality. So all those things inspire us, and that's the reason why we open restaurants, not because we are being told by someone that we should open it or we're forced by a financial institution or anything else. We're very independent in that way.
Yeah, okay, fantastic. So from your experience of starting your own business, what qualities do you think are important for somebody who's looking to go into a business?
Qualities, absolute resilience. I think you have to really listen to what people are saying to make sure you can filter the bullshit from the reality and make sure you can absorb the reality. One thing I've always done is I've always talked to as many people as I can about something, and I've always found a common consensus about things, about particular subjects. And if you take a lot of common consensus and put them together, you have something.
Yeah.
You know, that's teamwork, and that's teamwork with your future customers. Everyone is a customer, potentially. You can't serve absolutely everyone and keep absolutely everyone happy, but you can find the market. And that's how a lot of the market research that I do is in that way. A lot of the new product development that I do, if there's a new dish that I want to try, I'll talk to different people and let a lot of different people try it. or if there's a new restaurant location that I'm looking at, I'll do that as well. So yeah.
Okay, fantastic. So, quick one here. Entrepreneurs, do you think they're born or bred?
I think they're bred, definitely. I think we come from creativity, we come from sometimes even hardship and pain, sometimes desperately trying to change something to make other people's lives better. And so that takes a lot of focus that is not just inherited.
Yeah, good answer. So what's the one thing you wish you had known in the beginning? For people who are out there now thinking of starting a business, what can they learn from you?
You have to use the best of what you've got. I almost wish that I didn't know anything. It's really great to come with a chance view towards things as well. Yes, you need to acquire, in particular industries, you need to acquire specific skills that are specialist to that industry. And I did that very, very quickly. I've dipped in and out of hospitality through being a junior chef, through being a waiter and a barman, when I was at university or when I was younger. But then I used all my skills in concert promoting, in creating a song and making an album, in managing talent, and all of those come together. They're not exactly specific to the hospitality industry, and I didn't know them, but in the last few years, in the last sort of 2 years before we opened, I did a crash course, almost my own MBA, on how to be a chef and how to be a restaurateur. From research, from talking to people, from books, from reading, and that was a steep learning curve. You can start with a blank canvas, but you've got to learn a hell of a lot, and you've got to be prepared for that learning curve.
Yeah, and you've got to want it so much, I think, haven't you?
Desperately.
Yeah, that's the one thing that.
Yeah, you have to be. I always say you have to be an unstoppable train. You know, trains are heavy, big. Once they get going, they don't stop.
Yeah.
So if you can be like a train, you know, there's nothing to stop you.
Yeah.
And if you truthfully have got the intellect and the emotional intelligence also to know where you're going wrong and to listen to people when they're telling you you're going the wrong way, then you're okay to be a train. If you don't listen to people, then you're a stupid train that's going to just derail, and that's the worst thing, because it's very hard getting a train back on track.
Yeah. So finally, what one bit of advice would you give to somebody who is thinking about leaving a full-time job just like you did and starting a business?
First of all, go to a very quiet space. Might be for an hour, might be for a month. But think very, very deeply what's inside you. What do you absolutely love? What are the things that really, really make you happy? Not joyful, ecstatic, not, what's going to win you a prize. Mm-hmm. What just makes you content and happy? And then start your business from that. And see if your current job is giving you that. If it's not, then fuck that. Forget that. Put that to one side. Move on.
Yeah.
It's no time. Life's short. And by the way, working for somebody else is also super cool. If there's a set of values and a purpose in that work that's really high and really exciting. But if you want to start your own project, you can either do that with somebody else within a company or start from scratch. But just always look deep into your gut, feel what you really love.
What makes you
happy. And then follow that. Listen to yourself.
Fantastic. Awesome. Thank you so much, Martin. We're going to have to wrap up here. You're literally preparing for an event around us as we speak. So hopefully that sound and everything was okay. But thank you for listening, everybody. Again, thank you so much, Martin, for taking the time to speak to our lovely Facebook audience. It's great talking to you. And bye, everybody.
Bye.